Greetings, cyberdogs and citizens of the internet. This is Rendon coming at you from just outside the Molmart Bazaar in this Let's Play Minecraft Survival series. In the previous episode, we started working on the confectionery stand, the projector room, and the box office of the Cyberdog Drive-In. And in this episode, my friends, we are going on a mini adventure in search of diorite, granite, andesite, and seven more levels so that we can do a little bit more enchanting. Sit back and relax, my cyberdiggity dogs, with your tasty-ass beverage and crunchy-ass snacks, because it is mini adventure time in this Minecraft Survival Series! Every time I come back to Mole City, my heart fills with glee and joy, my friends. It is just so awesome around here, so freaking peaceful, and man, the Molmart Bazaar just takes my breath away every single time I see it. It is so freaking epic. But in today's episode, guys, we are doing a little something different because, well, we have been on a pretty much of a crafting binge for the last, I don't know, three or four episodes in this Minecraft Survival series, and in my new Kingdom Craft series also, I have been making a lot of stuff. I've made a giant ass railway system. I've just started working on a really awesome looking caravan emporium, and man, I have just been crafting my butthole off in Minecraft. In general, I mean, whenever I've loaded up Minecraft now for the last couple of weeks, all I've been doing is freaking crafting. So what I want to try and do today, guys, is just take my mind off some crafting and just go on an adventure with my cyber diggity dogs. I'm trying to get one of these Eyes of the Ender from Griswold over here so that we can make an ender chest. But what I thought we would do today, guys, is go on a little mini adventure in search of diorite, granite, and andesite, and also try and get back up to level 30. Of course, I lost 30 freaking levels on when I was working on the Cyberdog Drive-In build, so that didn't go down too well, and I need to get all of those freaking levels back so that we can carry on enchanting, so that we can get some really awesome enchanted books and make some sweet ass weapons. Of course, Mojang recently announced that Minecraft 1.9 is coming, and it is called the Combat Update. And what some of you Cyberdogs have been telling me in the comments of the previous videos is that we may be getting some new weapons in the new 1.9 Minecraft 1.9 update, and if that is the case, that means we're going to be able to add some fresh freaking tools and weapons to our arsenal, man, and that is going to be absolutely freaking awesome. So I want to get as many awesome enchanted books as humanly possible before then, so that when we get these new sweet ass weapons, we'll be able to enchant them and make them into something freaking awesome. So the plan for today, guys, is to head into the Nether and take the journey all the way to the Amazonia village, and then basically to go into the giant ass ravine that's very close to the Amazonia village to try and get ourselves a bit more loot and a few more levels. And I have literally brought the bare minimum with us today, guys. Let me get my iron helmet on now. Just brought a couple of ladders so we can climb around, oak wood planks in case we need them, got the compass to get back home, and a water bucket to be able to go up and down ravines. And I want to fill the rest of my inventory with some sweet ass loot, with some awesome andesite, diorite, and granite. And I want to start stockpiling those particular blocks, guys, because I want to start using them more. We've used a little bit of andesite on the road to the Cyberdog Drive-In and as the parking spaces in the Cyberdog Drive-In. But you know what, my friends? I think we need a little bit more andesite than that. I'm probably going to start using andesite in the Nether district of Mole City. I think that really dark looking color of andesite in this texture pack is going to be absolutely perfect for the Nether district. It's probably going to make up most of the floors. A lot of the sort of, I don't know, the gardens, I guess, will be made out of andesite and gravel and all of those sort of dark looking materials. And we haven't really had a chance to use diorite or granite yet either. So I think the sooner we start stockpiling that jazz, the sooner that we can start thinking about how we're going to be using them. And we are on level 24 also. And welcome to all of you guys who are perhaps new to this series. This is the village of Amazonia. Quite strangely, only female villagers spawn here for some reason. There are just ladies around here, man. Not that I'm complaining, but it is kind of weird. Yeah, there are still just ladies around here. I don't see any guys. Yeah, so not entirely sure how that is genetically working out, but hey, we don't ask any questions. We just move right on. But guys, this is actually still a 1.7 Minecraft chunk, so I'm thinking we might need to actually travel a little bit further. There is a giant-ass ravine over here somewhere, and Batty's actually come out to say, hello, what is going on, Batty? There is a giant ravine there, but what I'm thinking is maybe what we should do is head in this general direction. Is that a flower that we do not have? What is this? I don't think... Do we have this flower? Peony? I don't think we have this flower, people. I could be wrong, but I cannot for the life of me recall seeing this sort of pink flower in Mama Dom's greenhouse. So I'll happily collect that, man. That is awesome. We've already managed to pick up some fresh-ass new loot on this little mini-adventure. And by mini, guys, I mean that this adventure probably isn't going to last longer than 2 episodes. We're just going to find ourselves a nice, sweet-ass place to mine. We'll spend a bit of time down there mining, and then we'll go straight back home. And this is also looking like a flower that we don't have. What is this? Lilac? Do we have lilac? I am so confused right now. Because I don't remember seeing these. Man, look how sweet this mushroom looks. This might be... Man, the texture pack might be tricking us, though. We might be seeing different textures than we are used to. Because I'm using Optifine at the moment, and that might be changing the way the flowers look. Huh. Interesting. Well, I guess I'll take them back. I guess. What is this? I don't think we have this. What is this? A pink tulip. We definitely do not have a pink tulip. You know what I'm going to have to do, guys? I'm going to have to plant all of these flowers over here in kind of like a little orchard patch. And after our adventure, I'm going to have to come and collect them, I think. I'm not going to waste inventory spots on flowers at this point. I mean, as much as I love flowers, and let me tell you something, my friends, I freaking love flowers in Minecraft, that is. I think I'm just going to leave those there, and we know where they are. They're really close to the village of Amazonia there, so that we can just come back and collect them at some other point. But I think we're probably loading some new chunks now. I think we're loading one. We should be loading 1.8 chunks by now. And it looks like, what is going on over here? Is this, keep your eyeballs open for some diorite, andesite, or granite, my friends. Those are the ores that we are going to try and find on this adventure. The sun is going down, though, so that is slightly concerning. This is, of course, an Iron Man adventure today, guys. We've got a whole bunch of new fresh-ass iron armor on. We've got an iron sword also, which should hopefully do us a bit of justice and hopefully keep us safe. I'm not using any of my diamonds yet, guys, because I want to say rabbits! We found rabbits! Oh, hello! Hey, bunnies, what is up? Man, we need to get some of these bunnies back to Mole City, because Mole City is a 1.3 chunk, and there is no bunny action going on over there. And there is some fire over there. I don't know if you guys see this, but there is... Oh, yes, here we go. Here's some andesite. This is a 1.8 chunk, my friends. This is where we're going to be mining, but... There is fire going on over there. What? Okay, this warrants exploration. What is cracking down here? It's very, very seldom that we've seen fire like this in this series, guys. Okay, there's lava. There's lava about. That'll explain the fire. And you will burn. Oh, man, that creeper and that zombie ate the freaking dust there, man. Back up, son! Okay, creepers in the town. How awesome is this little lake? Look at this little lake, man. This little lake is so sweet. Oh, this is epic. I want to go see what that fire is all about. I'm assuming that there is another little patch of molten lava there. Spider, you want to back up, son? Oh, and guys, you may have noticed when I was trading 16 string for 1 emerald with one of the villagers. We found a ridiculous villager for trading, man. 16 string for 1 emerald. That is so cheap. She is definitely, basically, our best trade villager that there is, man. And we have a ridiculous amount of string, actually. So, oh my goodness, double creeper action. I don't know if I can handle this, man. Back up, you little green bastards. Back up, sons. Oh, God. All right. There is more lava here, which explains the burning fires around this place, guys. Well, this is kind of a scary dark oakwood forest. I'm not going to lie to you. What is actually through here? Oh man, there's a whole bunch. I think that's some swampage over there, and that looks like a spruce forest. Oh, epic, man. This is a beautiful part of our world. And this is why we need to come exploring a little bit more, guys. I mean, oh, look at this giant patch of lilac over here, too. You know, we're missing out on some really beautiful parts of our world, guys. So we definitely need to do a little bit more exploration up in here. But you know what, guys? I think I'm going to head back to that little andesite patch that we found in the beginning. Get set up for a little bit of mining, and let's see if we can get our inventory filled with some of the new 1.8 items, or 1.8 blocks rather, and hopefully I can find a cave or something around here too. So I'll bring you guys back in a second once I've found somewhere to set up camp. Oh my freaking Ender Gods, my friends, look how beautiful this little part of our world is, man. This is just absolutely gorgeous. Take a moment to take this in, my friends. Check it out, right? So what we actually have here is a couple of caves, and then we also have this little island of swampage in between this little delta. It's almost like a big stream running between this sort of mountain area over here, and there's a waterfall to the left. Man, this is such a beautiful area. Oh man, I love this place. If this was a brand new Minecraft world that we just started, I would be constructing my base right freaking here. Man, look at it. It's absolutely gorgeous. But I want to get into that cave over there, guys. I have found the entrance for today's mini adventure, and we need to just take out this freaking creeper. There we go. Man, I wish I had a stronger sword. I think on hard difficulty, an iron sword requires 3 hits on a creeper, or maybe even 4 to take it out. So I'm struggling to kill those little green bastards. Python's family, man. Python, keep your family out of my Minecraft survival world, man. What are the jads wrong with you pythons? Seriously. All right, there's an enderbud over here too. I think I want to try and kill him so I can get the experience and possibly get his pearl. Nice. Well, we get a bunch of XP from killing Enderman too. So that is nothing I'm going to complain about. But guys, let's get our buttholes into this cave. Oh yeah, baby. The adventure can finally begin. Oh yes, look at that. That's going deep down into the butthole of Minecraft. I want to get rid of a whole bunch of jazz though. I don't want any of these oak saplings. Lilac can get out of my life. This bone can get out of my life too. And this dark oak wood, in fact. Yeah, I think we can hang on to the dirt. We'll eventually collect a pile of that, I think. And we can head down in this general direction, guys. See if we can find ourselves some andesite, some diorite, and some granite. And possibly we could get lucky and find some gold at the very... some diamonds, rather. And at the very least, or the very worst, we could find some gold for Granny Dog's monument, man. So, you know what? Mini adventures, I'm a fan. I'm a fan. I don't know about you guys, man, but I'm a fan. They usually result in some good times, some good funs, and some good chats with my freaking cyber dogs, man. You know what, guys? I wanted to have a little... Oh, look at this, man. I've just broken into another section of this cave. Awesome. I wanted to have a chat with you guys about an experience that I had over the weekend. And, I want to chat with you about this because I want to see how many of you guys out there may have had a similar experience to what I went through. And if so, I'd love to know whether or not you guys managed to, I don't know, learn something from it and potentially heal from it too. How do we begin the story? Well, let's begin this story 2 years ago, almost to this day, in fact. So this is, what is this now? April the 8th, I think. April the 8th, is it? April the 9th? Something like that. A couple days after Easter weekend. This time, 2 years ago, my life fell apart. Essentially, I lost a couple of people in my life in very, very quick succession. And basically, everything around me kind of imploded. At the time, I had just sort of started my own business. I was trying to do YouTube full time. I spent a ridiculous amount of money on producing a game that was kind of going okay, but I was having a lot of difficulties with it also. And everything just basically exploded all at the same time. It really did feel like my entire life fell apart. And I also lost my granny dog, and oh man, I didn't lose my granny dog then. I think it was a little bit of time before. It was sort of 6 months before, but everything was just going wrong. You know, you get those periods in your life, guys, where everything just goes wrong, and you can't understand why, and you also kind of struggle to see an end to all of it. You know what I mean? Like, you kind of feel like there's gonna never be a positive end to what's happening in your life. But you know what, guys? I'm a testament to the fact that that is 100% not true, because I can tell you now that there was moments a couple of years ago where I was close to giving up, and not just giving up on Minecraft and YouTube. I mean giving up, and some of you guys will know exactly what I'm talking about. But anyway, that's where the story begins, because in those times, in those very testing and trying times that I went through, I had a couple of techniques that I used to escape what I was going through, right? And these techniques, I guess, are nothing special, nothing interesting or nothing unique, really. And I'm pretty sure that most human beings go through exactly the same kinds of techniques when they're going through difficult times. And what we tend to do as human beings is we try and find somewhere to escape what's going on in our everyday lives. And, you know, I've been talking about using YouTube as an escape from sort of cycling negative thoughts as a sort of therapy technique to try and get yourself out of a negative thought cycle. And that is basically what I'm talking about, right? Using something else to distract ourselves from what is actually happening in our lives at whatever moment we are going through, or those hard times that we are going through. And even though I believe that using distractions to break negative cycles is really helpful and really therapeutic, I also think that it can be quite dangerous, because what can happen is you can start relying on those distractions for your own happiness. And when those distractions are suddenly not there anymore, for instance, suddenly you feel you may regress back into depression, or you may regress back into the bad times that you were having when you were using those methods of distraction to help yourself. Now, there is another side to that, which is what I want to talk about, and which is what I think that I experienced on the weekend. And I think that I don't really know what to call it, but I kind of want to, I've been trying to think of a term for it, and I'm going to call it positive regression, right? That's the term that I'm going to put on what I'm going to tell you guys now, and I'll try and make sense of it. Now, let me explain exactly what I was doing this weekend. So it was Easter weekend. It was a nice long weekend, and I had Friday and Monday off from work, which was awesome. I was going to do a whole bunch of Minecraft recording. Unfortunately, my internet went down. I also recorded a whole bunch of hours of Minecraft Survival, but didn't record the audio, and I lost a bunch of that, and that was really frustrating. And instead, what I did was I spent a little bit of time with a new friend of mine, and we had an amazing freaking time together, a really awesome weekend, and it was fantastic. Now, when I got back to my flat on Sunday evening, I was really happy. I was so happy, actually, because I'd had such an awesome weekend. I went on a couple dates, I ate at some really nice restaurants, I got some nice presents, I was spoiled a bit. It was awesome. I was feeling a million bucks, man. When I got back to my flat, I thought, oh, well, you know, we better do some recording now, because we got to get videos ready for next week. And I thought to myself, you know what, actually, I'm just going to do something for me tonight. I'm just going to chill. I'm just going to do whatever I want. And I'm not going to worry about work. I'm not going to worry about YouTube. I'm not going to worry about recording. I'm just going to take it easy and maybe play a game that I hadn't played in a really long time. Now, my internet was going up and down this weekend, and because it was Easter weekend, we couldn't get any engineers out here to look at what was going on. So the internet was coming up and down. It would be up for an hour and then go down again. I don't know what was going on, but I think there was probably a fault in my area. However, despite that, I decided to play some Dota 2. Now, Dota 2 is a MOBA game. It's a 5v5 online game only, so it's a multiplayer game only, and Dota 2 comes from a game that is called Warcraft 3. And many, many years ago, probably like 15 years ago, I guess, maybe that's a little bit too long, but at least sort of 10 to 15 years ago, Warcraft 3 came out, and a person called Ice Frog made a custom map called Dota, Defense of the Ancients. And this map became so popular that Valve, many years later, created a game called Dota 2, and I do believe Ice Frog was involved in the creation of that game, which is basically a high-budget clone of the custom map that Ice Frog made in Warcraft 3. And Dota 2 is very, very similar to Dota 1, or the custom map of Dota 1, and it is, in my opinion, one of the best games ever made, because it is ridiculously fun, extremely challenging, and the more you play, the better you get, and the better you get, the more enjoyable it is. It is a highly skillful game that requires intense knowledge of the metagame, intense knowledge of spells, heroes. There's like over 50 heroes to choose from. They all have unique abilities, they all interact with each other uniquely, and so on. So becoming a master of Dota is a very long-winded affair. Now, 2 years ago, when I was going through some tough times, Dota was my escape mechanism. And I'd been playing Dota since the Warcraft 3 days for many, many years. I played Warcraft 3 Dota for probably 3 or 4 years. And we're talking like maybe 1 to 2 hours a day back in those days. So I'm pretty good at Dota. I like to think that I am anyway. And, you know, the reason that I found Dota to be such an excellent escape mechanism during these hard times of my life is because I was actually quite good at it. And what eventually happened was I ended up spending many, many, many hours of my life playing Dota 2 years ago. And when I say many hours, I'm talking about like close to 500-600 hours in about a 6 month period, which is a lot of time. You know, that is a lot of time that I spent playing Dota 2. And I racked up many, 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 many hours of that game. And I don't remember much from that period of my life 2 years ago. What I remember is sort of just like a big blur. It's all kind of just like one day. Jake, that creeper's listening to my story intently, man. He doesn't want to come and blow up. And what my days consisted of really was waking up on the couch, having something to eat, firing up my computer and playing Dota 2 for the rest of the day. I'd stop and have lunch. I'd go to the gym, which was another distraction technique that I was using. And I'd come back from the gym, have a shower, eat, play Dota, and I'd play Dota till 3, 4 in the morning, go to sleep on my couch, wake up the next day at 12, 11, 12 o'clock in the morning, and do it all over again. And it was an extremely damaging period of my life, because I basically burned through all of my savings living like that. You know, I still had to pay rent, still had to pay bills, still had to pay electricity, I still had to buy food, had to pay my gym membership, all of that jazz, man. So my savings basically just evaporated. But I was trapped in this world of Dota 2, a place where I was actually doing really well, where I would, you know, join a game and kick some butt. I had a couple of friends that I played with every day, and we made a pretty close and tight-knit group together, and we were kicking butt, man. We were climbing our way up the ladder, up the, you know, we were doing really well, man. We were getting our skills up, we were getting our XP levels all the way up to as strong as they could get. And I was in this world, and in that world there was no pain, there was no anger, there was none of that stuff, you know. There was just success. Success and victory. And it was an excellent place to be. Of course, it was an unsustainable place to be. No one can live like that. You know, life has to go on, man. You can't just sort of immerse yourself into a computer game and think that everything's going to get better, because a computer game is basically like sleeping, right? You're not doing anything. You're not achieving anything. Unless, of course, you're making videos on YouTube or something like that. But if you're just literally spending your days playing a computer game, you might as well be sleeping and dreaming, right? Because it's a completely selfish activity. The only brain that's getting stimulated by you playing computer games 24 hours a day is your own brain, and possibly the brains of those who are playing with you. But you are not sort of enhancing the life of anybody else. You're not enhancing your own life in any way. You may be slightly enhancing the entertainment level of your brain, but you're certainly not sort of enhancing your lifestyle in any way. So it is a very dangerous place to be, and I did recognize this after sort of 500 or 600 hours of Dota. And once my life started to stabilize and things started to get better again, and I didn't need Dota that much anymore, I stopped playing it, and I came back to YouTube, and I came back to making Minecraft videos, and here we are now. I mean, for those of you guys who were around 2 years ago, you'll remember there was a period where I kind of just disappeared. I just vanished without a trace, without saying anything, without even an email or a video message or anything like that. And I got to tell you guys, you know, to this day, I regret that. I think it's one of the worst things that I've ever done in my life. And, you know, I mean, all I can do is apologize to you guys for that. But, you know, that doesn't make it any better. It was still unacceptable behavior on my behalf. But I was trapped in the world of Dota 2. I was trapped in my positive reinforcement mechanism. I was trapped in my distraction, and I was trapped deep, very deep. However, all of that being said, I managed to claw my way out of there, and you know, I am now in probably the best place that I've been in my life in, man, since I can remember, actually. I'm extremely happy. So, you know, it shows you that even though you can go down to the very bottom of your staircase, you can get back up again and you can start climbing again. Now, that was a long-ass rant about Dota 2, but there is a purpose to it, guys, because what I am talking about and what I mentioned about 10 minutes ago was positive regression. And this weekend, when I was playing Dota 2, the internet was jumping in and out, and I would start playing, and sort of 20 or 30 minutes into a game, the internet would cut, and I would get kicked from the game. And in Dota 2, if you quit a game, you get sort of negative points put against you. You get downvotes. They're kind of like downvotes, I guess. And the more times this happens, you get put into like a what they call a low priority queue, where you can't sort of play with normal people. You have to play with the rest of the scum, the rest of the people who have been flaming or have been abusive or have been quitting games before finishing them. So you end up basically playing with the dregs of Dota society. And that's basically what started to happen to me. You know, my internet kept on cutting out and I kept on trying to play again. And I just thought, you know what, I'm just going to play some Dota today. I want to play like 3 or 4 games, maybe more. Just chill, enjoy it like I used to enjoy it, and take it from there. And you know what, guys, I played for about, I don't know, I must have played for about 5-6 hours, I guess. Had a really long Dota session. Had a couple of really nice, you know, fun little pieces of action that were really fun. But I finished playing that Dota session and I went back to my bedroom to go to sleep. And as I got into bed, I realized that I was extremely depressed. In fact, I felt a depression that I hadn't felt since 2 years ago. You know, when you feel that sort of depression, it's very obvious when it arrives. You know, you can feel it quite strongly because it's a very powerful emotion. And I could suddenly feel the same emotions that I was feeling 2 years ago coming back up again. And I couldn't understand why. And I thought to myself, oh no, I'm going back down the freaking hole again. I've tripped over a few stairs and I'm back down halfway, you know, halfway down my staircase again. What is going on here? And I thought about it for a few days, and yesterday when I was on the tube going to work, I suddenly had a freaking epiphany, man. What I realized is that I'm not regressing, I'm not falling down my staircase, I'm not going back down to the bottom. It was Dota that sent me there. It was a bit of something that I wanted to be positive, you know, I wanted to have fun playing Dota, that sent me into a regression. And that is why I call it positive regression. Because I was trying to do something positive for myself, something fun, something that I really wanted to do, but it ended up actually reigniting some serious emotions deep within my subconscious. And that's basically what I wanted to talk to you about today, guys. And I'm very interested to find out if some of you guys have had similar experiences to that. I mean, it doesn't necessarily have to be computer games. If you guys have used some other sort of escape mechanism to escape perhaps a hard time in your life. It could be anything, man. It could be even something like going to the gym, for example. Computer games are probably the easiest one because it's very easy to escape reality in a computer game because it's an alternative reality, isn't it? I mean, how much easier can it get to escape reality than to go to another one. But there are loads of others too, man. There's loads of other regression techniques that people use. Maybe going to bars. You know, there's very destructive ones too, like doing a lot of drinking. Maybe, you know, doing a lot of, I don't know, spending all your money traveling. I don't know, man. I'd love to know from you guys if you guys are willing to share with me some sort of honest stories from your own lives. Can you recognize any forms of positive regression that perhaps have happened in your own life? And if you were able to recognize them, that's awesome. If you recognize them now after I've spoken about them, then that is even more awesome, because that means that you can immediately stop going back to those positive regression techniques to try and you know, if you are doing one of those things and suddenly finding yourself really depressed and not knowing why, well, I think it's because of positive regression. Anyway, my friends, we have managed to jam-pack our inventory with, wow, a whole bunch of diorite, a whole bunch of andesite, and a little smattering of granite, which is epic. What I think I'm going to do now, guys, is try head down to the butthole of Minecraft so that we can find some obsidian, and then I can deposit these things into the ender chest and do a little bit more mining. But unfortunately, guys, we have run out of time in today's episode. I really hope you have enjoyed it. I really love these episodes personally, that I can just sort of, you know, get my mind out into a video, broadcast it to you guys, and hopefully connect with a few of you guys out there. And I hope you guys have enjoyed it. If you have, you know what to do, man. You smack that like button. If you haven't subscribed yet, well, it's very easy, man. You smack that subscribe button, or something freaking painful is going up your butt crack. Let me tell you that much. Thank you so much for watching this episode, my friends. This has been Ren Diggity Dog on a mini adventure playing Minecraft Survival. We will see you in the next episode.